A very good morning to all. Now, as you can see in the picture, a lady has purchased so many things. Now, how is the calculations going to be done? So basically, there is a electronic instrument which is going to weigh the product as well as the cost, and then the total calculations in the bill will be given. Now, all these things are done with the help of a billing machine or an electronic machine. Now, what I'm trying to tell you is that there are some calculations to be done. Now, basically, we need to get some shortcuts. So now in this, today we are going to study about algebraic expressions. How these algebraic calculations can be easy, and to make it quicker and to understand better, we are going to study this algebra calculation in the form of squares and its expansion. So now we are going to study about how algebraic calculations can be used on the basis of squares and expand them. So today we are going to study algebraic expansions using the formulas. Now before that, we should know how the formulas take place. A rectangle PQRS is given in the figure. Its length is y unit and its breadth is 2x unit. Okay, you can see how we are getting 2x. Now, a square of side x unit is cut out from this rectangle. We can use operations on algebraic expressions to find the area of the shaded part. Like how to do is, let us write the area of rectangle PQRS as area of quadrilateral PQRS. Now the area of the shaded part will be equal to area of PQRS minus area of quadrilateral NLRO. Now area of PQRS, it's a rectangle. You can see the length and breadth is 2x and y. So area of a rectangle is length into breadth. So 2xy. But quadrilateral NLRO is a square. Area of a square is side square. Since the side unit is x unit, it becomes x square. So the area of the shaded part is 2xy minus x square. Now area of the shaded part, area of quadrilateral PMOS minus area of quadrilateral MQLN. Now PMOS, y minus x. How do you get y minus x? X is already given. So that leftover is y minus x into 2x. 2x is the breadth of the quadrilateral PMOS. So area of quadrilateral PMOS is y minus x into 2x. Whereas the area of quadrilateral MQLN, as we can see the side is x, so it is x square. So now if we try to sort it out, 2x into y is 2xy minus 2x square plus x square. Now minus 2x plus x square will be minus x square. So the area of the shaded part is 2xy minus x square. Basically this expansion of squares is based on the formulas of a rectangle and area of a square. As we know, area of a rectangle is length into breadth and area of the square is side square. Hence comes into existence the calculation and expansion of squares. So what we are going to study is algebraic expressions. Algebraic expression is the calculation using the squares. Before understanding the expansion of squares, we are going to first understand that algebraic expression have different expressions. When we have a single term, it is called as a monomial. When we have two terms, it is called as a binomial. When we have three terms, it is called as a trinomial. And when it is more than three, we call it as a polynomial. But for our syllabus, we are going to study about binomial. That is only when two terms are involved. So now we will study the expanded form of the square of a binomial. Children, here square means multiplying the same number twice. Here square does not involve geometry square. We are studying algebraic. So this square is multiplying the same number twice. The product of algebraic expression is called their expansion or the expanded form. There are some formulae which will help in writing certain expansion. Like you can see here, x square plus xy. If I remove x common, it becomes x plus y. And that x plus y will be into bracket because x is a common factor to both the binomials. Now let's see one activity. You can see we have ABCD. Now in the given figure ABCD, the side of square ABCD is x plus y. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4 shades in the square. The square ABCD is divided into 4 rectangles 1, 2, 3, 4 as shown in the diagram. The quadrilateral ABCD, area of quadrilateral or square ABCD will be sum of the area of rectangles 1, 2, 3 and 4. So area of square ABCD will be area of rectangle 1 plus area of rectangle 2 plus area of rectangle 3 plus area of rectangle 4. When we sum up all the 4 rectangles, we are going to get area of a square. You can see the area of the square is x plus y square because x plus y is the side. Area of rectangle 1 is x square, side is x. Area of rectangle 2 is, now area of rectangle 2 is xy. Area of rectangle 3 is xy. Area of rectangle 4 is y square. You can see in the diagram. So now x plus y square is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. That means if x plus y square we open, we are going to get it as x square plus 2xy plus y square. Now let us multiply x plus y square. Now square means what? X plus y multiplied by x plus y. We have to multiply it two times. Now how we multiply the algebraic expression? X into x plus y plus y into x plus y. And then we further, x into x square, xy plus yx plus y square. Now 2 3s are 6 or 3 2s are 6. In the product form it means the same. So xy or yx is same. So xy and yx is 2xy. Hence x plus y square is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. The expression obtained by binomial x plus y is equal to the expression obtained by finding the square. Therefore, x plus y square is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square is the formula for expansion of the square of a binomial. That means whenever we have to expand x plus y square, that will be the answer. X square plus 2xy plus y square. Another activity. In the given figure, the square with the side A is divided into 4 rectangles. Namely, the square with side A minus B, square with side B and 2 rectangles A minus B and B. Area of square 1 plus rectangle 2 plus rectangle 3 plus area of square 4 is equal to the area of square MNOP. Now area of square 1 you can see will be A minus B the whole square. Then area of rectangle 2 will be A minus B into B. Area of rectangle 3 A minus B into B. And area of square 4 is equal to B square. And area of square MNOP is A square. Now if you write it in the order A minus B square plus AB minus B square plus AB minus B square plus B square is equal to A square after opening the brackets. Now A minus B the whole square plus 2AB minus 2B square plus B square is equal to A square. Now A minus B the square plus 2AB minus B square is equal to A square. So we get A minus B square is equal to A square minus 2AB plus B square. Now if we multiply the algebraic expression A minus B into A minus B, you can see how we multiply and then we get the answer as A square minus 2AB plus B square. Hence the expanded formula of A minus B the whole square will be equal to A square minus 2AB plus B square. You have to remember this formula, children, that A minus B the whole square is equal to A square minus 2AB plus B square. And if we take A plus B the whole square, this is going to be equal to A square plus 2AB plus B square. If it is A plus B, it is A square plus 2AB. If it is A minus B, it is going to be A square minus 2AB. I hope I'm clear with these two formulas. Thank you.